Drive ignition.
This is Actar's Reviews, from anime to figures and beyond. Hey, this is Actar and welcome to another Actar's Merchandise Reviews. In this day and age, it's nearly impossible to be an anime fan and not know about the series Suzumiya Haruhi no Yuutsu, or in English, The Melancholy of Suzumiya Haruhi, in some way or another. Personally, I think this series is simply brilliant. While definitely not Hayao Miyazaki, Satoshi Kon, Mamoru Hosoda good by any stretch of the imagination, the series was phenomenal in its own right, as it was over-the-top entertaining with its intriguing premise, lovable characters, fantastic sarcastic humor, and well-thought-out stories. Haruhi was in fact the second series alongside Lucky Star that convinced me that I would be the man who walks the path of otaku. Horrendous attempts at the Kamen Rider reference aside, sadly, the second season did not fare as well. It did, however, manage to deliver more Haruhi goodness to tide us over for the movie. Suzumiya Haruhi no Shoshitsu, or The Disappearance of Suzumiya Haruhi, which has finally been released on Blu-ray and DVD. Many have been saying that the disappearance arc from the Haruhi light novels is one of the best arcs of the series, and were hoping for it to get an anime adaptation as part of the second season. Thankfully, Kyoto Animation made the right decision to give the arc the treatment that it deserved and turned it into a feature-length film with a total runtime of 2 hours and 44 minutes. I'm not kidding! 2 hours and 44 minutes! That runtime would already be considered long for a live-action film, but for an animated film, that's just mind-blowing. And to put that into perspective, the Nanoha movie is 2 hours and 10 minutes long, the Evangelion movie 1 hour and 51 minutes, and the Macross Frontier movie 2 hours flat. And unlike any of these movies, the Haruhi movie is not a retelling or compilation movie, which makes it all the more impressive. A usual downfall with anime movies is that their pacing tends to be very episodic. For example, take the Evangelion 2.22 movie. It was fight, character interaction, fight, plot, fight, and you get the picture. And to a certain extent, the Nanoha movie was like this as well. The Haruhi movie, however, feels like a movie, and not like 8 episodes crammed together to form some semblance of a movie. The writing is tight, the story is riveting, and the animation is top-notch. Kyoto Animation pulled all the stops for this movie. The movement of the characters are all so fluid and natural, not to mention the movie feels so alive, as in each and every scene, you see a myriad of background characters moving and interacting with each other, just like you would a live-action movie. Kyoto Animation really put a ton of effort into even the most insignificant detail that would usually go unnoticed. All this in a bid to make the world seem as natural and alive as possible. Bravo, KyoAni, bravo. Praise aside, the movie does have one fatal flaw. You must have seen the original series to understand it. More specifically, you must have seen The Melancholy of Suzumiya Haruhi parts 1 through 6 and Bamboo Leaf Rhapsody of the second season. Not being a retelling movie, the movie wastes no time establishing or introducing the world or the characters to the audience, as it assumes that one is already familiar with the series. Throughout the movie, many past events are mentioned and referenced, but they are usually mentioned in passing and aren't really of much importance. I have absolutely zero intention of spoiling the movie for you, as this is an outstanding movie and is a must-see for any Haruhi fan. Though I would like to say that I thoroughly enjoyed it and in my opinion is the best anime movie of 2010, followed closely by the Nanoha movie. And with that off my chest, let's take a look at the main reason for this video's existence, the limited edition Blu-ray set. Does it do the movie justice? Well, let's find out. Now, before opening the Blu-ray set up, it's important to note that there are different bonus extras that come with this Blu-ray set depending on what online store you order them from. For instance, if you ordered yours from Amazon Japan, you'll get an exclusive steel case. If you ordered yours from Animate, you would get a Yuki Dakimakura cover and an A3 poster. Being one who is obsessed with replicas, I bought mine from Rakuten Books, where I got this. a set of replica bookmarks bearing messages from Yuki. Fans would instantly recognize this one from the second episode of the first season where Yuki wanted Kyon to meet her in the park. Now, this one is actually used in the movie, and to avoid spoilers, I won't be translating this one. As replicas go, they are pretty accurate. I was pleasantly surprised to see that they even replicated the snowflake print at the back, which was seen in the movie as well. Technically speaking, the snowflake print wasn't present on the first one, but that's just nitpicking. Of course, being made of regular bookmarkish material, they are pretty easily bendable and creasable. Right now, I'm on the hunt for a good copy of the Japanese hardcover edition of the book Hyperion by Dan Simmons to complement this replica. There's actually a secret code present on these two bookmarks that requires both of them to solve. See if you can solve it for yourselves. To be honest, I was kind of hoping for the one with the "I am here" message to be included as well, but I guess I'll take what I can. Coming back to the Blu-ray set, removing the slipcase presents you with the discs themselves and this physical extra, which we'll take a look at in a second. Interestingly, they decided to go for a rather unorthodox design for the discs packaging. You have to slide out the first layer to access the movie disc. While this is indeed unique, it's kind of annoying, and I fear that the cardboard will give way sooner or later. With regards to the discs themselves, the special features disc contains the following: location hunting at Conan Hospital, BGM recording scenes, stage greetings at Ikebukuro Cinema Sunshine, Shinjuku Ward 9, and at Kyoto Cinema, dubbing editing work scenes, theme song Yasashi Byokyaku, PV making video, and various TV spots and theoretical trailers. Altogether, that's 150 minutes worth of extras, which isn't too shabby. Personally, I find it really nice that it included so much behind the scenes / making of the movie. You really get to see all the work and effort that's required to make the movie as awesome as it is. I especially liked it when they compared the real life locations to the ones shown in the movie in the location scouting segment. All in all, I think that the extras are relatively decent, but I would really have loved to have seen more involvement with the voice actors and actresses, like interviews or voice recording sessions and the like. And now, we come to the main disc. Other than the movie, let's see, we have absolutely nothing. No subtitles, no commentary, no nothing. Honestly, this is quite a disappointment, considering the fact that most anime DVDs and Blu-rays have some sort of commentary or special feature. I am simply stunned that the Disappearance of Suzumiya Haruhi, a movie from such an established and popular franchise, did not get any commentary. It's just wasted potential right there. They could have done so much with this. Anyway, moving on, in terms of physical extras that come with the actual disc itself, we get advertisement after advertisement after advertisement after advertisement after advertisement after advertisement. Wonderful. But we do get a miniaturized version of the pamphlet that was given out in cinemas in Japan. It contains a story summary, character bios, character art, interviews with the staff and cast, and that's pretty much all there is inside here. We also have a set of cut it out yourself postcards. Yeah, not the best set of extras that I've ever encountered. But hold on a second, what about that book that we saw in the beginning? Well, this is actually the script for the movie. Now, other than replicas, I also have a soft spot for production material of any kind, hence my love for animation cells, film strips, and etc, etc, etc. However, there is a problem with this extra. For some reason, be it last minute changes or this being an older version of the script, it's not 100% accurate to the dialogue from the movie, which is kind of a pity. And yes, I did go through scenes from the movie with this script in hand. In conclusion, it's not easy for me to say this, but to be dreadfully honest, I am disappointed with this release. The extras disc is passable, the actual movie disc gives a new meaning to the phrase bare bones, and save the script, the physical extras are just kind of meh. The only thing I truly adore about this release is the replica Yuki bookmarks, and these are online store exclusive bonuses. Now, by no means is this a horrendous release, it's just that they could have done so much more with it. For any lesser movie, I would have said that this set is average, but for a stellar movie like The Disappearance of Suzumiya Haruhi, this is a letdown. So, I guess it all boils down to, do I recommend you pick the limited edition set up? Well, here's the deal. According to the manufacturer's standard retail price, the regular set is 8,000 yen, and it only comes with the movie disc and the miniaturized pamphlet. The limited edition set is only 1,000 yen more at 9,000 yen. For that extra 1,000 yen, you get the special packaging, extras disc with 150 minutes worth of footage, and the movie script. I think that for a fan, the extras are well worth the 1,000 yen. To sum it up, definitely pick up the limited edition set if you're a fan and are already thinking about picking up a copy of the movie in Blu-ray format. As disappointing as it is, the regular release is even worse. You can, however, take solace in the fact that the actual movie itself is well worth the money. So, this is Actar saying, see you guys in the next episode.